Welcome to season three of the nationally recognized award-winning Yours in Education show, where we spotlight the incredible people, programs, and partnerships shaping the future of students and families all across Placer County. Today, we're taking you inside the classroom where students are thinking like entrepreneurs, a high school engineering class with a Shark Tank style twist and a real cash prize on the line. Next, we'll show you how students at Rocklin High are diving into computer science, learning to code, develop websites, and even compete in cybersecurity, setting them up for the tech jobs of tomorrow.
You're dropping your child off, and you know your child's going to be cared for just the way you would care for them at home.
Then we shine the spotlight on a remarkable teacher who's been nurturing young learners for over three decades. She's making sure they start their education journey with love and care. Each of these stories highlights the power of connection, collaboration, and care in education. Stay tuned. You won't want to miss a moment. Welcome to a brand new season of Yours in Education, brought to you by the Placer County Office of Education. I'm your host, Kellie DeMarco, and with me as always is the Placer County Superintendent of Schools, Gayle Garbolino-Mojica. Great to see you, Gayle.
Nice to see you as well.
And a little bit more about Gayle. For nearly two decades, she has been a visionary leader and advocate for students and families. Her unwavering commitment to excellence for public education has really made a lasting impact, not just here in Placer County, but throughout California. And under Gayle's leadership, students continue to thrive, and Placer County sets the standard for educational excellence. So Gayle, March is Women's History Month, as you know. It's a time that we recognize incredible contributions of women throughout history. And in education, that impact is so huge because I'm reading here, in Placer County, 75% of your teachers are women. And as just one of a handful of female county superintendents when you were elected and a recipient of multiple leadership awards, what does this month mean to you personally?
You know, Kelly, when I was elected about 20 years ago, I was one of about 16 female superintendents out of 58 statewide. And as the years have progressed, you know, we have made gains in that number, and we are seeing more and more women that are moving into the county superintendent role. Another positive trend that I'm seeing is the number of female superintendents in Placer County. Again, I've been a superintendent in Placer County for about 25 years between being a district superintendent and a county superintendent. And this is the first year in those 25 years where actually 50% of the superintendents in Placer County are women. And I'm Wonderful. Just delighted that we're able to see so many women move into that leadership role.
I love that. And I have met some of them personally on our shoots when we're interviewing teachers and students, and they've been just wonderful to work with. So I love hearing those numbers. And I know, too, you've seen the role of women in education really evolve just in general as your time in superintendent.
You know, Kelly, one of the things that I am most passionate about is meeting teachers or vice principals or principals who decide that they really want to go into leadership in education. And they seek me out and they ask me, you know, what was my career path? How did I get to the position that I'm currently in? And I always love meeting with them. I love talking about my path. A lot of people think that there's one path, and there's so many optional ways in which you can come into educational leadership. And so I just enjoy my time mentoring and inspiring these young women, and it's something that I'm very passionate about.
I'm so glad you're such an advocate for women. It makes such a big difference in the workplace.
It does.
Well, another hot topic I wanted to discuss with you today is technology, because as we know, technology has really changed the way that we live, we work, and we learn. And Placer County students are being prepared for a tech-driven future like never before. So I'm curious how you've seen technology transform with your students over time.
You know, Kelly, I don't want to date myself, but I fear that I am. When I was a teacher, I remember we were very excited because we got email and that we could communicate with teachers and parents with email. Now what we're seeing is we're seeing the evolution of technology in our classrooms, from smart boards to engaging with iPads or Chromebooks. We do assessments on Chromebooks now. Hmm. We have 3D digital printers in our classrooms. We have students that are working on coding. Students who are in elementary school who are working on coding. We're seeing students now experiment with virtual reality. I think as we contend to evolve the role of AI, for example, we're only back where I was with in the mid-1990s with getting email and being excited about that. I think there's so much more ahead of us in the area of AI, and that is drastically going to change how we educate kids in our world.
I noticed with my daughter at 10 years old, she's on the iPad, she's on the laptop. We didn't have any of those tools, and I imagine it's just going to help kids.
It really does. You know, I try to get onto school campuses every couple of weeks, and I walk into classrooms. I walk into third grade classrooms or second grade classrooms, and I see kids engaged with their Chromebook or their laptop, working in a small group. And so I think today's teachers are really competent on how they integrate technology into the classroom in a really meaningful manner.
That's smart. It's the wave of the future. Well, it's not just about using technology in the classroom, as Gayle mentioned, but it's really about preparing these students to think like innovators. And all across Placer County, schools are offering hands-on programs, introducing students to coding, as she talked about, engineering, real-world problem solving. And one great example of that is the Shark Tank engineering class at Lincoln High School, where they're challenged to design and pitch their own creative solutions, just like real entrepreneurs. Let's take a look.
You have a probe in it, right?
Walk me through it.
You want to add some more weight to it, though?
Is the controller bad or the battery dead?
The Shark Tank is the last class in a four-class sequence. Where students learn basically a combination of engineering and business. They start by coming up with an idea of a product they're gonna make in our machine shop, and then they take that product and develop it into like a prototype, and then they go out and they meet with sharks.
That's really kind of what we wanna see in the Shark Tank, is who's gonna bust their butt and do a great job.
So let's go back to your ledger.
Part of the class is they also have to go through the business side of it, like rent a commercial space to run their business out of. Buy computers, pay their salaries, pay insurance and utilities and payroll and all of the other things. They have unexpected expenses, so we have what's called the Wheel of Doom.
The car runs into the water main for your building. Share is $2,300.
They have to basically manage their business while they manufacture their startup company.
So there's two sharks per group now. One's kind of the finance business side, and one's the technical side. So for this year, I'm the technical side. Obviously, there is something in it for me. One is just giving back to the school. Number two is recruiting. We're recruiting kids all the time. So within those groups, I'm picking personalities in our teams more than I would say that I'm looking for technical ability within those groups.
We're making nameplates, and it's been going pretty well. We got done the manufacturing stuff for a semester, and now we're on like the selling portion. That's a little more tricky because that's definitely new. But right now we need to like find buyers and then get a finished, finalized product and even like box it up and make sure it's completely professional.
So I would really say the Shark Tank is your first chance to figure out if you have a passion out there and what that might be.
Students pick a product, anything from like a coaster to a lightsaber to a Goofy Goober guitar to a puzzle. License plate frames are being made this year in the hopes at the end of the year they have produced somewhere between 5 and 10 products of whatever they designed.
He's doing a really good job.
And kept their business afloat and made it valuable over the course of the year.
This is a ton of fun for me. I think it's a ton of fun for them. And I'm sort of their first employer, I guess you could say, or business partner. And so how do they do working with somebody who's a leader who's not their teacher at school?
And this is 0.2 thick. How thick is this?
It's extremely gratifying to see them learn from all of this and to see the growth. I mean, I'm thankful for the district. Like, one thing I'll say here is they've never restricted me. Like, the answer's never no. It's always been like, well, if I could figure it out, they're always on board. So that's been a huge help.
Scott's onto something that nobody else has. So he needs every bit of support he can, because I think this is truly life-changing for a whole bunch of high school kids.
And there's a little motivation to win the year-long challenge. Whichever team makes the most fake money actually gets real money, thanks to a $3,000 scholarship donated by the Lincoln Rotary Club. So we are wishing Mr. Sechrist students the very best of luck this year. Well, now to Rocklin High School, where students are diving into computer science, learning everything from coding and cybersecurity to robotics and web development. Let's take a look at how teachers are shaping the next generation of tech leaders.
Another thing we could possibly try is trying to take in numbers of different types.
The great thing about the computer science program is that we actually have three different pathways. We have lots of options for people with different interests.
When they work with our industry partners, they realize how important what they're doing actually is and how it actually applies to the workplace.
I've been able to learn how to program in Python. I got some experience with Java. I learned more about networking, and I learned how to repair Chromebooks from like a complete scratch. So now I can take all these skills and take them with me into the workforce, and I already have experience to put on my resume.
We happen to have an Overwatch team that they are the national champions. They have won 7 national titles in Overwatch. It's amazing to look at all the trophies in the room.
It's a completely a problem-solving class. And when they solve a problem, whether it's simple or whether it's really intricate, you hear them yell out, "I finally figured it out." And so, yeah, that's pretty inspiring.
And I think more than anything, though, is that we try to establish, how do you manage your projects? How do you interact with adults? How do you work on teams? And that foundation will carry them through each of our pathways, and then, of course, will be useful to them regardless of the profession they choose later on.
And for those who want to take it even further, there are leadership opportunities and advanced courses that give students real-world experience at Rocklin High. And while technology and innovation are shaping the future of education, at the heart of it all, as you know, are the incredible teachers who make a lasting impact on students every day. Nora Rodvold is a dedicated preschool teacher who spent more than 3 decades nurturing young learners at First Street Preschool. Let's see how she's inspiring these very little ones from the very start.
Tell me, how many legs do they have?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6. That's right.
And he's wearing a costume.
Oh my gosh, Nora. She is the most sweet person that you will ever meet. When I walk into her classroom, I feel like I want to join with her. I want to get on the floor and join with the children.
And this is how you write number 8.
I love being with these young children. They keep me young. Preschool is the foundation. We're here to mold, to develop their skills. We teach them physical skills, social, emotional, and cognitive.
10, give me 5, yay!
They're eager to learn. Their vocabulary is so rich.
You're gonna buy them at the birthday party.
My grandsons are 4 years old, and they are doing remarkable. I walked in the classroom to pick them up, and she goes, "Oh, I have to show you what we're gonna be starting to do."
Cupcake.
I'm thinking in my head, compound words at age 4? You're teaching them already that? She goes, "Oh yeah, they'll get it quick."
The kid says, "Teacher Nora, what is sunflowers?" And so I start drawing a sun, and then the flower. I said, "Sun plus flower makes," and then they will say, "Sunflower."
I think it sets them up for success because they want to go to school rather than having to go to school.
You're dropping your child off, and you know your child's gonna be cared for just the way you would care for them at home.
Did you problem solve? Good.
I love teaching preschool. The enjoyment, their faces, their smiles, and their hugs. I want to feel them loved and be respected.
I know ants.
Yes, you remember.
They brought me joy, and that is why I'm still teaching for 35 years.
Wow, 35 years. I love how Nora says that her students keep her young.
You know what? I am so happy that we have teachers in our county like Nora who come to school every single day with such enthusiasm and professionalism. I think she's one of the reasons why we have wonderful teachers in our county.
Her kids seem so happy. Just so fun to watch that story.
It's great.
Well, our next episode focuses on Mental Health Awareness Month. Student mental health is critical to success in school and in life. And we're going to take a look at PCOE's state preschools, where learning goes beyond just the ABCs and 1-2-3s. This early childhood wellness team is really helping our youngest learners feel safe and supported. And then we're going to shine a light on the IPBIS efforts in Western Placer, where integrated mental health supports are creating a foundation for learning. New episodes launch every other month, so be sure to hit subscribe to stay updated and never miss a story. We'd love to hear from you, so leave a comment below to let us know what programs or topics you'd like us to feature. And don't forget, you can check out all of our past episodes for more inspiring stories about education in Placer County.
Thanks for watching, and thanks for keeping Placer County Golden Education.